Clayton Casanova. This is the Eagle Vision.
Let go.
Track.
Let go.
Baseball returns to the playoffs this year after a one-year absence by beating Livingston 14-0. The baseball team has made the playoffs 5 out of the last 6 years.
After a very tough non-district schedule, which included the likes of the Woodlands, Brenham, Montgomery, those type of teams, we felt pretty good going to our district schedule. I felt like we'd do very well, and we did do very well, winning a district championship against Huntsville in the bottom of the 7th, and that was very exciting. And it's also a good testament to our guys for hanging in there after playing such a tough non-district schedule. It's a good testament for them to keep working hard, and it paid off for them. Next year, we're going to lose a lot in Brent Turner, but we have a good nucleus of players coming back. We have our entire infield should be coming back. We'll have Michael Miller returning on the mound. We got some good freshmen and sophomores that could help us next year. Our outfield should be coming back intact, but losing Brent Turner and his 11-0 record, that's going to be losing a lot as far as pitching is concerned.
Track looks promising for the next couple of years. Track coaches Carla Williams and Casey Hubble finished with 3 players qualifying for regional competition. Daniel Von Quintes in the 110 hurdle, and Courtney Bridges, who is only a sophomore, was district champion in both shot put and discus. Christian White also qualified in the 400 meter dash. White was district champion. Track members train hard for the competition, and with 2 of the 3 regional qualifiers returning next year, the team should be strong. Basketball and cross-country competitors were honored at their end-of-the-year banquet in the cafeteria. Jarrett Smith, Zach Baker, and Adam Sykes were given awards.
And I don't want to take a whole lot of time, but at the same time, they deserve just a little bit of recognition individually. I just started thinking about today and just over this past week, just a few things that these individuals has done, whether it's something kind of funny or goofy or like a highlight. And the first thing that came to my mind was something that happened as a team. We had a double overtime game at CE King, probably one of our first games of the year. Ended up losing because I think we made like 12 out of 35 free throws. So you can imagine what we worked on in practice the next week. But it was fun. And Shane Calise, actually the varsity player at the end of the year, played for us in one game. I can remember him. Scored 27 points, and he had gone like, I think 0 of 6 from the free throw line the first game. Came back in the tournament and hit 10 of 11, scored 27 points. And I think we beat some team like 80 to 30 or something. It was just bad.
I thought it was a great season. Not as many wins as we'd hoped to have, but the record was 7-24, and we had 5 seniors that were with us the whole season, and I think we got better, you know, as the season went on. We were playing really well in district play. We lost a couple games by 1 or 2 points that, you know, could have really turned around as far as making playoffs. I just was real excited about how the attitude and the hard work just continually got better throughout the season.
I think this team this year was more united
than any other year I've played. Before games, we would all go to a friend's house or something and go play video games and have a good time and stuff. But then when we got to the locker room before our game, we were all mentally ready for the game that was about to take place. And then you made it to the hallway, and it was just about time for the game, and that's all you could think about. Something to say for the underclassmen that are coming up, to listen to your coaches, they're your mentors. They know what they're talking about. Everybody needs to listen to them. Don't ever talk back. Stuff. It's bad news. It's bad. Everybody needs to step up to be a leader. No one's over anyone in high school basketball. No players. You need to work hard over the summer to get yourself better for the upcoming year.
The academic decathlon program at New Caney High School has been one of the most successful programs in the high school. The teams from New Caney have finished within the top four in state for the past 6 years in a row. This past year, the team again finished as the second team in the entire state of Texas, and as such, each of the members of the team received college scholarships, with one of the members receiving almost $8,000 in college scholarships. United States Congressman Kevin Brady came to present to each of the members of the team a proclamation from the United States House of Representatives acknowledging their second place finish in state, and to individually congratulate and to encourage each of them.